all-new KTM Duke 250 came as a surprise from the company. While most of us thought that the 250 will replace the 200 at an almost similar price point, the updated 390 created a big enough pricing gap for KTM to slot in the 250. The Duke 250 is an interesting machine. Looks and almost all the hardware are from the Duke 390, with the 250 getting the new 2017 chassis plus subframe combo. But it has a unique headlight with halogens instead of the LEDs on the 390. What it misses out are the new electronics like the ride-by-wire, ABS and its modes, and the funky new color display. Once you get going on this new quarter-liter Duke, you're instantly surprised by the sound and the refinement levels. It has a better sounding exhaust note, a more throatier and smoother version than what we're used to. The engine produces 30 PS of power at 9000 RPM and 24 Nm of torque at 7250 RPM. The power delivery is not dramatic, but speeds do build up quite fast. The 0 to 100 came up in 8.3 seconds and the bike quite easily touched the 130 km per hour mark. Below the 5k RPM mark, it shows none of the urgency like the Dukes we're used to. Keep the revs below 5k and the bike is almost surprisingly silent. But once the revs touch 6k, the Duke 250 quite literally starts to take off. This difference is very noticeable, and if you're not prepared for it, it can catch you by surprise. If you're on one of your speedruns with a lot of corner carving, then we would really recommend watching out for this transition point and keep the revs higher. But the good thing is that this is not hard, especially with the slipper clutch making sure you do not lock up the rear wheel when frantically downshifting. Out on the highway, comfortable cruising speeds are around the 110 km per hour mark. At this speed, the motor would be spinning at just above 6500 RPM. In city, the typical Duke character remains. With all the torque coming in at higher revs, you need to work that gearbox to keep momentum. The gearbox in itself is quite sure-footed and allows precise, reassuring shifts. The PowerS's slipper clutch has also reduced the number of springs inside the unit, making clutch pull quite light. Now, the Dukes were never really known for their fuel efficiency, and the 250 is no different. Punish the throttle and you can see the numbers drop to the low 20s. But ride it sanely and it should return about 27 km to the litre consistently. Dimensions-wise, the Duke 250 is pretty much the same as the older 200. The new chassis and the larger tank though has resulted in a final curb weight of 161 kgs. But the good thing is that this has not affected the handling of the machine. The typical nimble and easy to ride character remains, and you can change directions at will. You have a light overall feeling, which gives you confidence, allowing you to easily throw it into a corner and pick it up effortlessly as well. The 250 also gets the new 2017 suspensions at both ends, but it remains stiff overall. The 41mm front forks handle sharp bumps much better, and being open cartridge keeps tuning as an update later a possibility. With all the performance and handling prowess on the Duke 250, the brakes are a complex story. The same brakes from the 200 are carried over, and while we initially thought they would not suffice, the sharp initial bite with a good progressive feel gives you good support. But it needs conscious additional force than what you're used to. Not something you would enjoy if you're the type that grabs the brake with one or two fingers. This makes ABS all the more necessary on this machine, which unfortunately is not available even as an option. The Duke 250 comes with the MRF C1 tire range, and while we are fans of this particular model, it does take a bit of heating up before the tires start to hold up to some aggressive riding. On the flip side, these tires should last substantially longer while still providing higher grip levels than the previous MRF version. The overall build quality on the new 27 Dukes look much better than before, but we did notice some jagged ends. One that we should particularly mention is the new side-swung exhaust. It definitely should have better finish levels. The seat height is at 830mm, which might be a point of concern for shorter riders, especially in stop-and-go traffic. The seat in itself is now softer and wider for both the rider and pillion. This should enable you to really use the larger 13.0-litre steel tank to good use. Although the instrument console is from the older Duke 200, it now gets two additional features. One is that now it shows the real-time fuel consumption, and the other is that it shows when the kill switch is on. One thing that we really love on the Duke 250 is its headlights. They are extremely good, and even with oncoming light, it had good throw and spread. The new KTM Duke 250, or rather both the 390 and the 250, have a design that is inspired from the Super Duke. This has made the Duke 250 quite striking and beautiful looking from any angle. It's sharp, it's angled, and while the engine refinement and performance has gone up a notch, the looks has gone up multiple notches. Surely, existing Duke owners must be a jealous bunch now. The new KTM Duke 250 bundles up the Duke experience in a package that makes it more appealing to a larger audience. There are some kinks in its armor, but overall it has a very strong appeal and a price tag that makes it all the more interesting.